You know who you look like is Bam Margera. Bam and Phil.
Hey, I'm Icarito. Welcome to Strap.
A rolling stone gathers no moss. A rolling stone gathers no moss. So as far as I can see, guess I was meant to be just a rolling stone. A rolling stone.
How would you describe your look?
Well, I was going for Janikowski. I think I ended up on the side of Fred Durst. So I think it's like the I-10 corridor, North Florida look. I can roll
just where I please. Tallahassee is a place that it's hard to love and impossible to leave. It's the state capital of Florida, and it couldn't be more removed from what most people think of as Florida. In some ways, it has some qualities like a miniature little Washington, D.C. In some ways, it feels like a really big college town. Yeah, but I think we have a real lack of sort of confidence in ourselves. You know, there's a lot of pride here, but I think people aren't really sure why.
How would you describe Tallahassee for somebody who's never been here?
Country.
For 3 months a year, we walk around in what feels like the devil's jockstrap. It's the worst possible kind of heat you can possibly imagine. But then the other 7, you know, months of the year, it's absolutely perfect. And I think we all kind of feel like we found this little corner of paradise here, and it's kind of weird. You walk around and you're like, why doesn't everyone know about this?
The golf scene in Tallahassee. So, I mean, it's so unique. You know, Tallahassee golf is unique to Florida, especially. You know, one of the great things about Tallahassee is the price. You know, one of the things, you know, you keep the price down to make it affordable to families, students.
And for the city, what makes us different, and because I know that golf is typically for rich people or people have a lot of money, but that's not what we're about. And I think that's why we're an important piece for the city, is because we're not about that. We want to get people out there. We want to make it affordable. We want to be there for everyone.
All right, Neil.
What's up?
So you're my brother. You always got my
brother. Sister. I got your 9 o'clock. I got your 6 o'clock.
Please speak after the tone.
Capital City Country Club, Tallahassee, Florida.
Okay.
How do you feel about Country Club in the name of this place?
That feels
like a red flag, no?
A little bit.
It's not great.
My name is Jay Revell. We are at my beloved Capital City Country Club.
What I've been told, never been there, like, semi-public doesn't even begin to describe what it is. I think it's completely public, but with a membership.
We're a country club in name only, you might say. You know, back when this clubhouse that we have, which looks like a dilapidated elementary school, was first constructed, you know, it was the social epicenter, hardcore private club in town. So in 1914, we built the first 9 holes out here by a British architect named H.H. Barker. And for about 20 years, it was a 9-hole course, very popular. Gene Sarazen popped in here once. You know, that was a big deal back in the day. Fast forward 20 years, 1936, we secured the services of A.W. Tillinghast. As part of a Works Progress Administration grant, expanded the golf course to 18 holes. And we're very fortunate to have a really unique golf course in Florida. It's very hilly, covered in massive live oak trees. It really looks more like, you know, Georgia on my mind versus Margaritaville.
Used to be private and it fell on some hard times, maybe?
That's a good question.
A friend of mine says we should rename it Windfall Country Club because about every 5 years we're staring at the verge of certain death and some fluke thing happens that allows us to keep surviving. Tallahassee's got, we got an abundance of golf. A lot of it is because we've got, you know, like a handful of failed country clubs. If this was for a different community, a lot of these places might be closed off.
How'd you guys do for coffee?
Check it out.
That's been a problem in the
past.
Looks
like Randy brought his own. I was concerned.
True straps of them. And, oh my gosh, this is fun. Upper Arlington Faculty Appreciation Night. What an honor. They gave it to me.
God. That's awesome. Neil, did you get some coffee?
So I was rushing a little bit, trying to get my friend Nurse look together. Turns out, Tron left this in the Kill House fridge. It's like a, I don't even know.
Where's it from? Brownberg.
Yeah.
Very expensive.
It's got to be like a $9 coffee just sitting in the fridge, day old. And I said, you know what? I'll take that. Thank you very much. I got a breakfast bar. You know, listen, I think the boys are ahead of the game already.
Is it good?
It is. I mean, it's a day old, but it's good.
Golf has just always had a real special place in my life. My grandfather was a head pro, a little 9-hole course about 20 miles north of here. I've always done a lot of writing professionally for different things, but I never really thought to write about golf. Oddly enough, the place that really triggered that, the first time I ever went to Sweetens Cove, I remember sitting in a meeting the next Monday, and I truly felt like something was different. What I found, the stuff that tends to resonate most with people who, you know, the small fraction of the world who tends to read my stuff is very personal, very first person. I did a book last year that was sort of a collection of those things. I tell everybody I write Jay Revell stories. They are for some, not for all. But if you like getting out and contemplating, you know, life and golf and everything in between, they're kind of fun to read.
Oh my God, Creed is from Tallahassee.
Really?
Yes, it says Creed. How about that GIF, the one of him at the Cowboys game?
It's so good.
God, when the guys, the shirtless guy's flying.
I think people don't want to admit this. I think Creed, I don't listen to him. But every now and again, you'll catch a Creed song. It kind of bangs for a little.
It slaps a little.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hold me now. I'm 6 feet from the edge and I'm the gift.
If you don't admit that Creed is catchy, you take yourself too seriously.
Truly the cleanest bathrooms maybe in America.
Well, what's
truck
the other
stop
one?
Wise.
Bucky's?
Yeah, this is our Bucky's.
Okay.
Kinda.
It's a lot. You know, Neil was asking to buy everything in the store. I had to tell him no. I gotta be the bad guy.
Well, he was buying something.
Really? He just had a Kind bar.
I thought this was a sensible purchase. It keeps me from getting hangry. I think that's a good investment in my energy.
Will you
energy.
Give me a bite of that?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Of course. You have a banana, though, you know?
What were your preconceived notions of Tallahassee?
God, I have none. It was very easy drive. I-10, straight shot west. What, 3 hours, would you say? A little over 3 hours?
The capital city plus college town is a very interesting vibe. I'm going to try to think of some other ones. Austin, Texas. Columbus, Ohio.
Madison, Wisconsin. One of those was crazy was when they made Tallahassee, everything like south of Gainesville was just trees and swamp.
It reminds me of the original Brasilia. The capital of Brazil, where they were just like, they had like Rio and they had Sao Paulo. They're like, nah, we're going like inland, maybe. We're going into the Amazon. We're just gonna build a city from scratch because we needed to be in like the center of the country. West Florida, East Florida, and they tried to, a couple of dudes died of malaria trying to get back and forth, the legislative.
Back when it was like a territory, Jay was giving us a whole history. He was very knowledgeable.
If you're interested, look that up, because I thought that was really interesting.
That was a sprawling answer.
What was the question?
I think anybody's free to book a tea time online. So to me, it's like, come on, it's not a country club.
I would call the clubhouse just the vibe when we pulled in and everything, romantically tired. Like, just, you know, God, this place could use a facelift if you're just if you're being super objective, but at the same time, you're like, yeah, but who cares? Like, it works, man. You know, you kind of go
is
in.
Is it detracting from everybody's enjoyment?
No, exactly. It's like, nah, man. Like, come on.
There's some rust in a few places, and we get by. And really what it's all about now is golf and community and people who really like spending time with each other and laughing at each other. You know, if you're a country club that's willing to laugh at just your state of being, you tend to attract a certain kind of membership.
Maybe because they have to. It's like, it seems like they're putting the money to what matters.
Tennis courts look great. Golf courses look great.
It was very homey.
felt like people were enjoying themselves.
I bring my dog out here a lot. I tell people you can get away with a lot at a fledgling country club. The rules kind of tend to go out the window a little bit. This is my dear, beloved pal, Leon.
That's Levon.
He loves it out here. We live a few blocks from the golf course and have a lot of fun out here, especially in the summertime, late evenings.
I think going after my nuts.
Is that signed?
By Norman himself. Ooh. By the shark himself. Actually got a buy one, get one free at Nike Outlet.
Oh, we're not doing that.
So in honor of in honor of Free Shoes University.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Technically a free pair of LeBrons.
Stat bylaws state we have to play the one-up tees.
I'm in for that. I've got
so,
no shame.
You know, we tee it forward.
What's the bet or money moves y'all got going on for this round?
So there's usually not really a set. Tomorrow's the money round.
Okay.
That's kind of the set game. Otherwise, sometimes we play against the NARC. Sometimes we play against our host.
Maybe a beer and nine per side.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right? A beer Nassau?
A beer Nassau.
Come on, Jay. Let's fuck him up.
Oh, God. That is so safe.
That stinks, but
it'll
work.
Love that, Randy.
Oh,
you're gonna like that.
What do?
I really enjoyed a few different holes here. The first hole is special in a few ways. It's actually kind of a little tantalizing. When we have tournaments and things going on, the veranda and the driving range are right next to the first tee. So a little bit of asshole tightening going on when you're trying to, you know, get one through a pretty tight chute on the first hole.
Comfy four there, partner. Hey, good four. All square after one.
The second hole is a real banger. It's an absolutely beautiful natural hole.
I call it the Tallahassee bunt cut.
Pretty good.
Really good.
Yeah.
Oh,
I really called you.
Do it to him, partner.
Oh,
wow.
It was a really fun, little charming, not even like little. It played a lot longer than the yardage. 6270?
Yeah, it's like 6300. Tons of, like, just, dude, there's no way you can cut the corner. Like, you can try, but you're gonna get slapped in the face if you try. Like, don't do that. Kind of like you try to bully the place.
Yeah, it wasn't very bullyable.
134, yeah, I gotta imagine playing at least 140, if not more.
Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Much more hilly than I ever would have expected.
Much more hilly. You know, I've always thought that Florida was just pretty much flat all the way across the state. But
right.
It was this and Lick Creek, I think, two hardest walks in Strapped history.
Find one?
Yellow, super high.
Back to zero. Back to neutral, homeostasis.
I love the seventh hole. It's a par five that goes over this hill, and I always tell everybody if it was, you know, the ocean on the other side of the green instead of Magnolia Avenue, it'd be in a lot of magazines.
Oh, wow.
Partner.
1539, Hernando de Soto.
Boy, yeah.
Ever heard of him?
Took his big tour around the southeastern United States, set up his winter encampment. They always knew it was somewhere near here. They figured out that it was literally just off of 13 Green over there where we were, where they basically camped out.
You guys pressing?
Yeah,
we're pressed.
You haven't lost one of these in a while. You know the beers come out of your budget.
Yeah, cold domestics.
Jay, we kind of fucked him up on the front side there.
What do you got to do?
Lord, I mean, I just winked at you. No, this is what a cool opportunity.
That's not very good. Mr. Big played the game the right way.
Very cool, man.
Very cool.
Can you imagine some people want to change that rule? That you should be able to move that?
I feel so much better about myself.
The fuck kind of sand? I want to see some speed, Randy.
Mr. Landis always played the ball down.
Always.
Settle. Hey, that's good.
Settle.
Hey.
A lot of talent.
Par putt after all that.
Yeah, those were scary shots right there.
Be a truly all world four. Not his best.
How'd that miss?
Oh, yeah.
What? Plus one in the turnover battle?
I told Randy I gotta go check it on. I see a couple balls over there. Found a pie, man. Found another Truvis. Plus one, baby. That's how you shift the momentum. Turnover battle. Going right?
I think right at the end. I think you might have some influence to your left up there.
I see. It's not what I'm doing.
All right, the boys lose the front. They lose the press. Four down on the 18th.
Jesus. Tough nine right there. It's never going to be easy. We didn't come over here wanting it to be easy.
We're on uncharted territory.
DeSoto and the boys didn't have it easy when they landed in the Tallahassee area. So, whole new nine. That's putting that all behind
DeSoto,
us.
DeSoto, it's all in the past.
Yeah, we burned the boats,
but we're moving forward.
It's kind of the first time the Diner boys have really been punched in the mouth. We didn't get off the bus on the front nine. I was like, man, I feel like there's a couple of high school football games. I remember, you know, you watch the film. And these guys, man, they're no good. You're playing grab ass on the bus. You're just not locked in. We weren't locked in.
No.
And then you get off the bus, and like all of a sudden you're not like 14 nothing.
No, but it's one of those games, too, from the coaching side where it's like the coach knows. Like,
yeah.
He just knows that's what's going to be the issue.
But it was also one of those games where you show up, yeah, and you're spatted up. Oh, you know, I'm going to try out these new bicep bands or like, you know, like kind of like my chinny chin chin with my Greg Norman hat. Then you start playing like shit. And you're like, man, I look like such a fluffer.
Knock it tight.
Don't try it.
When I tried to bully 10, I felt like, you ever seen that movie, Life of Pi?
Of course.
Or the book, you read the book?
God damn it. See ya.
Jesus, man. I'm in the wilderness.
I felt like a drift, and like Leon was like the tiger. And I was like, oh God, like... Tough scene.
Of all the places you
yeah, no, that's what I thought too.
But then I kind of locked in and was like, cool, we got a road to Mexico.
Do you think all those
basically what happened to him?
Do you think all those animals are just in his head?
I mean, we can take that offline.
Hey, putt.
Very nice.
Good four.
Very nice.
No blood.
God, Diner Boy is gonna have to make a showing on the back, huh?
Yeah.
Running out of hole.
The health inspector's shutting us down.
I had to fly the drone for a couple holes. What happened?
That is the way the kids will play. My partner Neil made a great birdie, followed up by myself rolling in a putt for birdie. Our third consecutive
hole
that we've won. So you guys are...
So we're one up?
One up on the 18. Neil and I are three up on the 9.
Jesus. All right. I got to get back to work.
Back in it.
Dear God.
Oh, no!
Dude, that dirt kept that thing.
I thought the dirt, yeah,
it
was going to set it over.
Like it leaned, and then just settled back on that mud pot.
Carter, let me do one thing for you.
Sure.
We're back.
Hey, great to have you back, Pioneer.
Thank you. Great to be back.
That is fucking beautiful.
Shot. It's Jay for Eagle. Stretch out. Really good.
Oh my gosh.
Neil for birdie.
Hell yeah.
Great putt.
Was her in on the back nine? I told you.
There was some opportunity out here.
Great bird, buddy.
No blood.
Very nice birdie out of you.
Good bird.
God, that sucks.
Oh, my God. Go all the way down.
Oh, man. Can't sit there, bud. Can't sit there. You're on my mark.
There's the effort.
Nice.
Wow.
There.
Really good.
I really struggle on slow Bermuda greens. Like when they lose speed, they just, the green just like takes them like a riptide out, you know, like blown out to sea. Like, and then, you know, a 5 footer doesn't even hit the hole. You're like, man, that wasn't that bad of a putt, was it? Like, and that's a very much a public golf feeling.
Southern public golf.
Yeah, like, God, they know where I'm going to feel like that, and it's usually on strap, which is sweet.
Want a piece of corn? Maybe it might be really good. Okay. It's going to depend on the...
That's what I was trying to do.
Depends on the bounce.
Getting greedy.
Oh, could be really good.
Hit the fucking putt.
All right, no blood. No, we pressed. Yeah, you're right.
You pressed.
So, yeah, so you can still press if you want.
I think we got pressed. Because if we win this hole and we don't press, it's nothing. Mm-hmm. So if we win this hole with a press, an extra press, we get a cool piece.
Oh, like right there.
Oh my God,
it's like the right.
For all the marbles here, for birdie, an 18.
That's good.
That is good.
Hey,
enjoy
it.
We won 3 holes. We fought back and just won enough.
And we paid our debts. The Strap Boys paid their debts. We owed 2 cold domestics, and as
two
they
each,
do,
two each.
I know that. But it starts to matter.
I felt like a good community back deck. I thought Muni, I wouldn't say Muni, but I'd say like, man, it was like, I would felt out of place just walking up there.
No, it didn't. It's not pretentious.
It had like Forest Park. I said to you, Forest Park, like just the look of it.
Plug in the scores. Hold
on. Hey, come on, dude. What do you get my grill for?
Plug in scores in? Many people saying that.
Come on.
No one's saying shit. I shot 43-37. So if you're going to say I was sandbagging,
maybe
I didn't. I kind of
tanked now that handicaps update every day.
No.
Maybe you tanked to try to get one more stroke for the money round tomorrow.
Everybody knows that's your move.
I mean, that's out of your playbook, dude. That's like a, yeah, you know, if I killed her, this is what I would have done.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
It's not like, how it works, dude.
This is a true game recognized game easy situation.
Easy Uncle Juice.
I think.
Oh, see, oh. I told you it's narrow.
That's our carport there, fellas.
That one? The lit one?
Yeah, the lit one, the second one.
I thought you guys have been living a little high on the hog, to be honest.
I was
going to
say, we let the narc pick this one. Is this like a drug den or something?
We're going to all find out together. Okay. The reviews were very mixed.
I mean, I feel kind of confident about this. Notice this area is under 24 hours video surveillance, but I wonder why that needs to be there.
Maybe it's just for appearances.
For sure. All right, let's see what's
kind of like your goatee. Don't show them the code. Can't believe
we have a focus place for us. We've also lost on the cold beers, so this saves us a little money.
This is fine. What are you talking about?
Fuck, man.
It smells a little like smoke.
I think the shark head gave me like a fucking crash or something. Is there anything there?
Is this a bit? It seems like you just had a lot of cats in it. We got some yellow.
No, those are just yellow.
Cases.
Maybe not.
Yo, you had a good call with the cats thing earlier. I feel my nose already starting to fucking revolt on me.
Really?
I got dander issues.
It just looks like a place cats would be.
It does. It just looks like they had their own room over there and shit.
I thought you were punishing us.
I'm not punishing you.
That's your
I feel like this is pretty, like...
It feels like you're punching.
No, this was, like, I looked at all the options, and this was...
All of them? Did you look
this
at
was
all
for
the
sure
options?
Not the cheapest one.
Really?
Yes. And it's really close to the golf course. All
right, well...
And I think you guys could both admit, if you had a shred of humility, that the run you've been on for Airbnbs has been second to none.
This is one of those cool things where you can write words on it. The narc. Fuck the narc.
That's really cool, man.
That's
really fucking cool. After I booked
this, you want to start a war with the Strat Boys? This is what you're in for.
You are the Rocket Man.
Cool.
Yeah. Shredder.
You know what?
You got the fluffy pillow? Oh my god, look at this.
Yo! No, no, no.
What are you doing?
I might get cold. I like to leave the fan on and have an extra blanket. So.
You got pillows in here?
After the fucking reception I got from you guys.
Listen, like I said,
you can hold on to each other overnight. How about that?
What do you think you're gonna do with your hands full over there?
This is exactly
resourceful, as I said.
This is exactly what people would expect. Because Neil immediately turns to violence.
No, just threats.
That's all he took.
Right now.
You know, call the cops? Call the cops.
Just like a spring or a summer's breeze, I can roll just where I please. I'm just a rolling stone.